time. Trust in me and you will find. And time goes by so naturally while you receive infinity. Okay, Shauna here for the energy report. Long time no see, no hear, no nothing. It's been a while since I've been in. And I said I would come back in June when the energies switch, and they've switched. And if you're into energy as I am, you would have felt that switch. It's like you're cruising along and all of a sudden you just hit a speed bump. That's what it's like. And it's like, oh, did we upset the egg carton in the back or not? For some people, the egg carton is a bust. And for some people, their eggs are safe. So we'll see where everybody's headed here. Yeah, I've been out of the field, literally. I just not tapping in. Just recently, I had a situation where I tapped in. So I thought, here we go again. The universe will put you in a position to use your abilities when need be. So yeah, and also I've been following a few people over this while, one of them being David Wilcox. I put a lot of his sessions up. I'm going to have to put another one up before I even start this, because he's got a lot cutting edge material there. If you do not know what the energy is doing, man, this guy clues you right in. He zooms you right in to the facts, Jack. So I will post that at the beginning before I start the energy report. My plan is to get into this report and also to get a masculine and feminine report out there before I start into the series. If life gets in the way, then we'll have a little lengthier time here in between all of that. If things go smoothly, then we will continue. So forgive me for my sniffling. We got 9 cards here from different decks. Now, one of the decks, I'm not too sure if I'm actually going to be able to get visuals for it, but I'll get some of some sort. The first deck I have is the White Sage Tarot. It's a small, again, we're with the animals here. Then the Black Cat's Tarot, and then we end off with a clarification card from the Oracle cards, and also the Angelarium are coming in here, and they are heavy on the angelic side. You know, what they're giving me the sense of already here, when I haven't even flipped a card yet, is these Angelarium cards have a dark and a light side to them. I read the light side, but the visual is of dark. So it's like we're overcoming the darkness that we see from the spiritual source. So this is, you know, this is part of what this reading is going to be about. I'd like to say this is for the spiritually advanced, but there's a lot of people that may just trickle in here. That, you know, they may not think they're advanced. So we'll just see. If it resonates, it resonates. Okay, we're going to start out with this White Sage Tarot. And the first card that we have for the energy report into June plus. I'm kidding. So it could be up to 3 months this could apply, or until I do the next reading here. So your first Sage card, everybody. Eight of Pentacles, talking about ambition. Eight of Pentacles usually symbolizes getting to work and getting things done. I know in my life, this is what I am doing right now. So this, it can attribute to past energy, can attribute to everybody getting down to their spiritual selves and working. It may be in your physical world, but we may be also coming across spiritual lessons here having to do with where we are prompted to go in our physical world. That makes sense. So what I'm trying to say is you may have an agenda on the physical earth, but your spirituality will not be far from you, trailing with lessons and realizations and epiphanies and things about the outer world here. Sorry, I'm adjusting my recording studio. Where was I? The parameters between spiritual and physical world, right? We go in doing the physical thing on the physical earth, and the universe is right behind tugging you in your instinct and bringing you all these spiritual things. So I feel like that's going to be kind of pretty close to the overall lesson that's happening here over this time. But nonetheless, bringing our ambition forth and making that prominent quite highly, working on things. Again, this past energy. So the next card, as we dip into the present tense, we get the Five of Pentacles, talking about ill health. Yeah, well, I've come across this myself, having ear, nose, and throat problems, right? Ear colds and all that kind of thing. We may be dealing with physical, Okay, they want me to explain, for those that don't know, and I think a lot of you already do, the fact that if you don't get your spiritual tests done, your physical world will start to crumble. In fact, I think I touched base on that in the last energy report talk, and this one or the last one, I'm not sure, talking about how if we don't follow our spiritual selves, if we resist energy that is coming in instinctively, that we can fall ill physically. Again, there's a Bible that I read. I call it a Bible, but it's a mental cause for physical illness. The metaphysical way to overcome the body, heal your body, by Louise Hayes. She's kind of the groundbreaker in this area, opening us up, talking about epiphanies, right? There's always a physical root to some of these problems. You may want to, if you're interested in all this and you're going through it, you may want to look that up. If you got pain in the physical body, there's a root cause of that. Okay, you know what? They're going. Example. Okay, so I've got ear, nose, and throat. So you look up in this book, and the one I've got is Heal Your Body, and it's just literally the book of, it's like a dictionary for all the areas. So if you have constipation problems, mouth problems, nail problem, nail biting, holding fluids, hernia, fever, death, you know, all these things have problems. Well, death, I think you're over the problems if you're there, but so all of this stuff, right? So let's look up. Because what was mine is nose. So we'll look up nose. A, B, C, D, G, K, L, M. Nose. Because it's running, right? This is what I've had for the last while. Everything's running. My nose, throat is erupting. So runny nose, asking for help, inner crying. Now, so this is the root, okay? Asking for help, crying on the inside. Now, she also has a solution. So we go down the road here. There's three columns. And in the third column, it gives you the mental mantra that you can, one, you could just visualize and say, okay. And it says, I love and comfort myself in ways that are pleasing to me. So it's like focusing on yourself with love and comfort. So this is a solution to having this thing. So me erupting in this way means that I'm not comforting myself in ways that are pleasing to me. May not be paying enough attention to the self, this kind of thing. So you can go through this. They got like from A to Z, literally. The last one is yeast infection. Won't go there. I'll let you figure that out if that's your problem. But yeah, it's got everything. Back problems, apathy, anxiety, Alzheimer's, abdominal cramps, you know, all of this. It's all in there. So have a look at her stuff. If you don't know of her, I'm pretty sure you've heard of her. If you haven't, look her up, man. She can help you throughout this time. So the physical body is could be erupting, right? In the present, we could be going through physical symptoms of spiritual issues. This is what's going on. So this is what will be highlighted. And again, it's kind of, how would you say, it's kind of like the last resort. Well, we got to hit the body and, you know, we're clogging up areas here, and how it hits everybody's different, right? Well, not really, because she's putting it down to a Bible, right? You can say that if you have this, it means this. And she's done a lot of research. She was back in the 80s there, late 80s, 90s. when the AIDS epidemic was out, that's when she'd already done a lot of research by then, but that's when she really came out with her stuff outward to help those people. Okay, because there's eruptions, right? Anyway, we'll continue on to the next card, which brings us into the future. So we started with ambition, and a lot of us may be feeling, in the recent past here, very ambitious, very driven to accomplish things in our life in the physical plane. And because of this, we may have blockages here. And because of that, we may have ill health that is alerting us to these blockages. But if we're not aware there's a correlation there, we'll miss it. So be aware of that. And in the future, we have the White Sage, the Page of Swords, which brings about a clear vision about facing issues head on. And I feel like that's their goal. Their goal is to make you aware clearly of your issues through illness and health. I know that sounds weird, but truly that it is what it is. Like a lot of it is pretty logical. I haven't had time to study a lot of this, word for word, right down to every little thing. But a lot of people that are into this energy, I've heard them say it's pretty logical. When you have a pain in the neck, it means something's bothering you, not paying attention to. So it erupts as a pain. You know, there's a reason that saying comes out in the way that it does. You're being a pain in the neck. It creates a pain because there's something that we're not paying attention to that is, you know, this kind of thing. Or what was another one? Yeah, like your feet. I was having problems with my feet a while back, but I had an accident with my foot. And that, again, it's all from the depths of alerting you. We're coming into a new vibration here where we have to really puzzle piece everything together. And when the physical body, no matter whether it's an accident that causes this pain initially, it's still a weak point in the body that is, blown out and made an example of. And then when we pay attention to it, like your feet move you forward. And they say any injuries to the feet is about a fear of moving forward or not wanting to move forward, you know. And they say the knees are what hold you all together, hold you to stand up. And if your knees buckle, it could be like a stubbornness to want to face reality, right? All these things, they have these root causes. And I feel like in the future, we may not know exactly these correlations, but we're definitely going to have a better viewpoint or a clear vision of where and how we want to deal with things in the future. Not only because that vibration is hitting us head on. Like, okay, how do we, yeah, they're going, how do we give an example of this in the real world? Okay, well, the only thing I can attribute is tuning forks, right? And you've heard, if you have anything to do with music or musically inclined, tuning forks are, they're just, there's something that can sit there, and then when you twang them, then they vibrate, and they send that energy field out. And it's very obvious, because if you have another one sitting next to it, it will, signal that other one to go. So, okay, give me a moment here to put it all together. That energy field that goes out to that next tuning fork that's not doing anything, you're the tuning fork that's not doing anything. The universe has put out a vibration, and you're going to start to vibrate just by locality alone. You're going to be there, and you're going to start vibrating. And this is the clear vision. That's the only way they're going, yeah, that's fair enough. It's not exactly the way they'd put it, right? Of course, they would not be using words per se. But it's like we are in it. You can't get out of it. You can't remove yourself from it, though people try, like in the last reading. Ouch, ouch, I don't want to get hit by the high vibrations, right? So we're in it. So now, if you can't beat them, you join them. You start humming. You start vibrating. And that vibrational frequency that you hit, OK, okay? Without trying, by the way, because like I said, if your feet are on the earth, you're going to start. It's the earth that is really sending this vibration upwards. There's a lot of other influences that could be, but I won't get into that. Because there's enough polarized positives here that we keep it to the righteous vibration, right? Not any counterbalancing vibrations. Okay, so I think I'm getting a little too far gone. They're going, no, keep going. But the Page of Swords is about truth, and it's about clarity and that vision. And again, when you know what you're seeing and you see the truth and you feel the truth, there's a certain kind of frequency that hits you that says, okay, I know what I'm doing, I know where I'm going, and I know what I want. And then you just go there with courage, really, because you feel it on all levels. This is kind of the thing. So for people that don't know where they were going or what they were doing in their life, they will come across things more naturally that will veer them off into directions that will be more productive. If you're feeling non-productive, you will get productive, not only in ways where you're just getting busy, but ways that you're more fine-tuned to what you truly want instead of gravitating to things that are okay or wishy-washy about. You're going to go in directions that are highly attuned to you, meaning highly that something means to you, right? From a deeper center of who you are. Okay, let's go into the second level here. We'll get into the black cats, kind of bring me out of, yeah. So the Eight of Pentacles, that's that ambition in the past. I do feel like we're getting down to work, whether it was on the, I think a lot of us on the physical earth, we're just getting back into things. You know, after the COVIDs and all of that stuff, we're just getting right back into the swing of things, getting into the physical earth and trying to ground back down to where we were, even though it's going to be different. So on top of that ambition of the past, the Black Cat Tarot is 18, the Moon. Yeah. And here we have the Moon kind of lighting our way. And this person is kind of releasing themselves to the Moon. So it's almost like the sense they're giving me here is, illusions abound. We're going forward. Don't matter what the illusion is. We're going to figure it out. I feel like a confidence here in, how would you explain that? A confidence in the unknown. A confidence that no matter what it is out there, it can't trip me up because I'm in my clarity. This kind of thing. And not only that, if we're talking about past energy, I feel like no matter what the illusion is around us, we're just going to do what we need to do to get forward here. And anything that's an illusion, well, we'll figure it out as we go kind of thing. It's kind of the confidence to just keep pushing forward. So again, it's past energy, but immediate past. Some of you is still in this. Some of you is still just discovering this. And some of you are passing over into the clearer vision of this. Where the illusions are going to start to lift, okay? So that is good because it's like giving up to the illusion. Some people, they'll run around and go, I don't know, I can't see, I don't know where I'm going to step, I can't go anywhere because it's too dark, I can't see, I don't know what's going on. That's not you guys. You guys, there's illusions going on, you're like, you know what, I don't care what's going on outside of me, I'm taking a step forward, I'm going to take another step forward. If I can't see, I'm going to see that I got footing, and that's all I need to get me through to the next round here. And that's what's going on. The courage of your convictions is what they said. So taking courage of our convictions, no matter what illusions are abound, this is good. So it's kind of breaking through. That's how you break through them, right? And another thing they were saying last time was, how do you break through illusions? You talk to your fellow man. You talk to the person next to you and say, is this what you're experiencing? Or is the news, is that true? You live over there. What's going on over there, right? These kinds of things. You check it out. And it makes sense or don't make sense. And then your illusion crumbles, right? Because suddenly you talk with these natives and they're going, okay, this is not what's happening here. You know, and then you go, oh, okay, that's not what's happening. So then it disappears. Okay, this is what's going on here. This is good, or what has been. So as we get into the present with the Cat Tarot, on top of the ill health, again, some people may be getting, I mean, how would I explain that? They just gave me a dump of stuff. Because I was talking about ill health, and then they was talking about karma. They're sending me lots of people are going to be going through karma at this time. So those that are doing that, they could have ill health due to that. There could be something going on in their life right now that is karmically inclined, meaning they are paying off karma in a physical debt kind of way. So this is something they're dealing with right at this time. Now, the Black Cat on top of there, we get, is that the Knight? Or the Page of Swords? This is hard to tell in this deck. I think it's the Knight because it's got the thing, yeah. So he's hovering in and amongst these mountains, right? Knight of Swords. He usually, he's got a kind of wicked look on his face, like, what are you up to, right? Ill health. Not being happy in this scenario. Some of you who are paying off karma, well, if you're in ill health, it could be just a symptom of dissatisfaction in the mental body, these kind of things. It's beyond dissatisfaction. It is a rejection of certain things. It can accumulate in physical form in the body. So whether it's karmic or just simply a rejection of certain things, thought forms that are creating blockages in the body, we're not happy about this. We're, yeah. There's a sense of wanting to get underneath this, which is case in point what the universe really wants you to suss out here if we're talking universal energies. Now, I'm saying that because I'm getting a feedback already about people going, there is no universe. There's no interplay. You could believe that. And then you would have a hard time finding these blockages, these issues that you can't get over. You're right, to a certain degree. There is not a universe in the way of a speaking, prompting person that's going to come and say, you can't do this, you can do this. But there is a balancing of energy that happens, and an imbalance of energy that can happen, and a blockage. Think about plumbing. When we have a blockage in a certain area, it affects something else, or something erupts, this kind of thing. It's like that. And just because you don't believe in plumbing, you don't see the pipes running through your homes, is all hidden, doesn't mean it's not working in the background. Same idea. And for those people that are in rejection mode and don't have a belief system in this way, this is quite perturbing because they are not seeing a way out. They're not seeing a solution. They're not open to look in the areas to get the answers that they need. So again, belief systems here are going to create havoc because it will prevent you from finding solutions to what is going on here. But if you're here, you're rooting around in the right area because you're believing in things that are unseen, and you need to do that in order, again, on the light side, of course, but you need to go in those areas in order to, you know, for some people, they just will not get out of the ill health mode, okay? But for others, you know, there's paths here that are supposed to open up. They're supposed to be illuminated. It's part of their path. And for those, you know, that you could be going through a struggle at this time where we're frustrated because we're not coming across this. Okay, as we move into the Page of Swords, again, in the future, there's going to be clear vision. We're going to come across epiphanies, whether it's, you know, an increase in vibration that brings us to a knowledge, or just the knowledge smacking us in the face. Universally, like we just hear something sideways from somebody else. Like sometimes you're just standing in line at the grocery store and you hear someone talking, you know, about a subject that's something that you wouldn't bring up. You wouldn't even talk about, frankly. But you get it that way. That's what I call a sidewinder. because it comes in when you ain't even looking for it. And then there it is. It just sits with you. And then suddenly you can't get what you heard out of your mind. But it could be the exact answer you need to hear that you weren't looking for. This kind of stuff. That's the Page of Swords energy that's coming in the future. Now, the Cat Tarot on top of that. What do you know? Ace of Cups. Okay. Yeah, this says to me highly. Not only are those people who, and I know I have a problem with this myself because I get wound up, right? Everybody can get wound up in their anger, like road rage, you know. You get me on a bad day, like, look out. I can be like 10 sailors in one body. It's just the F-bombs are flying. Everything's flying. But the whole heart of all the answers will only come when we are of love in the heart, in compassion in the heart, of softness in the heart. So if you have a bad day and you're bumping into things and nothing's making sense and da-da-da-da-da, if you go to bed and you say, okay, tomorrow's another day, let's reboot this sucker, you go to bed and you wake up and you pray, like, can I please have a better day tomorrow? And what do you know? You wake up in your compassion. The birds are singing outside. There's a soft glow in the sun shining over the grass in the morning. And suddenly, you're in love. Or at least, in a compassionate sense, where your universe isn't the same as it was the day before. Now, let's get into this mode, shall we? The Ace of Cups. That's about joy, fulfillment, enjoyment of yourself, people around you, and the universe. And once you get in this mode, this is the mode that is in reception. This is the mode that we can give you those little guidance. And even when you're off base or off balance, they can throw a sidewinder at you. But the best mode to be in is your love and compassion in order to receive things that are for your highest good. If you are not in love and compassion, right, this is where the clear vision will go out the window. Then you get steamy windows, foggy windows, you get, you know, just mud on the windows, whatever. You don't see all the clarity that the universe wants to give you because you're not coming from heart and compassion. You're coming from anger, bitterness, and resentment. It's the same thing as law of attraction with, you know, I'm going to have a good day today rather than, oh my God, it's one of those days. Am I, you know, is it going to be one of those days? And everybody gets in that habit of doing that. Or, you know, this is habits that we should be letting go. We should just be, like, saying more often, what do I say? Yeah, things just go my way. They're going to go my way. But you have to have one thing happen that's good in order to start the ball rolling. Or you can just say it first thing in the morning when you see that vision of the sun shining on the trees, on the grass, and everything is going good. Then you can just take a moment, not to reflect, but to accept, you know, today's going to be better. Today is going to be a better day, da da da. This, all this simplistic stuff, right? That's what they're saying. The clarity will come when the heart is in the right place. Okay, that's bringing it down to one sentence. Okay. We'll get into the Angelarium cards. We got three of those. So the first of the three here, on top of the moon energy, again, working in the past, we may have illusions, but we're having the courage to break through and just keep going no matter what illusions may be abound. On top of that energy, we get Sandal Fawn, the angel of new life. And this is always my twin flame card, because these two, it's like they're connected. So they did say to me, there will be some twins coming together over this year. I quit saying in the fall because every fall it's like I don't hear of any. Mind you, this last year I'm hearing of more people breaking up that shouldn't be together. And then that makes room for that perfect partner. So, you know, new life could be upon you here. Now, this is the past energy. And I feel like for some people, right? Because not all people are on that path. And I don't like the twinsies. I don't like using that. It's a very bit embittered because, one, it's been stretched to the limit and morphed and mutified and you know, it just, everybody's just stripped it of its value, really. And those that are in it, they'll know they're in it. And those that aren't, well, it won't matter, right? Because you're all looking for soulmates. You're looking for a partner to be in life with, to go along with life with, and to settle down with. So I feel like that is kind of some energy that's sitting here. And I'll give me a minute. Yeah, we may have illusions about who our perfect partner is. And again, I'm going to say it. I just said I wasn't going to say it. By fall, those illusions will be gone. We will. We may have some people here just happier than they've ever been with people that may be in delusion. Okay, either you or them or both of us are in delusion. And I'll tell you, the universe will not allow, even though it feels swimmingly at this point, the universe is going to put those of the highest frequency together. If you are one of those people that are behind the eight ball in the way of working on the self to become your highest self and to work on your own, these people will be having problems no matter. So, Angel of New Life, that's kind of the harbinger of, like, we're looking, like, there's energy here of getting together with soulmates. So that's just hovering here. And it at this time, I feel, in the past into the present. So some people are going to still be dealing with people they think are their partners, but they're not really their partners. They're not of their highest good. It may be a partner, but it may be one that karmically we are done with, and we need to move on to a new higher soulmate, which may be hard for some people to do because some people have low frequency, how would you say, lower expectations, and so they don't see themselves going to a higher person. They'll go, no, that's too far gone, I can't do that. That's, and so those people may have a bumpy ride here because they may be hanging on to a lower frequency when they need to go to a higher frequency to evolve. So they may be in resistance of evolving at this time. Oh, there's a lot of stuff coming through. Okay. It's just basically a lot of energy about that, about the fact that some people are going to be hanging on to mates that it's just going to spiral downward more and more and more. So anyway, the next row here as we get into the present, again, there may be some people battling ill health due to spiritual struggles and having a frustrating time seeing it that way because a lot of people don't look at it that way. They don't see the correlation between physical and spiritual. There should not be, you know. So as we move on to that card, the Angelarium card we get is the right eye talking about wisdom. I can't pronounce that name. Chokma, something like that. Right eye talking about wisdom. Give me a moment. I have to tap in here. Gaining the wisdom of, yeah, higher realms here. Because we are, for those people that are in any kind of struggle here, and I think we all are in different kind of ways, different areas, right? We're in struggles trying to figure out our life. We may be in struggles trying to figure out our physical life. Maybe in struggles trying to figure out different areas where we may be blocked or clogged in some kind of way energetically. I feel like what the right eye wisdom is coming down to, it's interesting because I was just looking up the left ear and the right ear talking about wisdom and, you know, ringing in the ears and whatnot. And they say the right is universal wisdom is the right side. And the left is infiltration from negative. So when we talk about the right eye, that's seeing things from the right perspective. So some of you is maybe having a hard time doing this is the sense, because they're bringing me back to that Knight of Swords energy where it's like we're getting wisdom, we're being downloaded with it, we're being instinctively driven by it, but we may not be following it, and that may be leading us to physical health problems because we are not doing that. We're not following things through our instinctive wisdom self. Our higher self is trying to guide us, and we're not listening. This is causing eruptions in the physical body. This. Okay. And we're upset because we may not believe that, right? We may not believe that which is happening. We may not understand. We may not. It's a belief system thing here. So you're going, well, I don't believe that not listening to my instinct is going to cause me to have a physical problem. So therefore, I cannot go in that area and find an answer because I'm not looking there. This is what I'm getting. Okay, for some people, that's the way it's going to be. Okay, as we move on to the future here. Yeah, they're going not far down the line for most of us. Again, we're destined to get clear vision in the future if we come from love and compassion. Our Ace of Cups, we have to come from love and compassion of self. And then we go outward to our fellow man or woman and we do the same, right? And that this will contribute to the betterment of you and all of humanity. Now, on top of that, Angelarium card we get. Right hand, talking about empathy. Mm-hmm. She said, I don't know what that means. Okay, so we're talking about rights and left here. And we're staying on the right side. All the angel cards they're giving me is on the right side. So the right hand, talking about empathy. And what we're talking about, love and compassion, is all part of that train that choo-choos along with the empathy. And if we can receive with empathy, they're giving me the sense here. Because my mind was going, if we have empathy for the fellow man and we give empathy outward, that's a good thing. But what they're correcting me, they're going, the right hand, having empathy for our fellow man, in a good way going outward, this is what will create the clarity. So for those people, and you know, I found this in my life as well, and even though I'm in a point where I'm really self-focused or focusing on my physical world to a degree that I am really shutting a lot out, I shut the, because sometimes when you get into energy work and whatnot, it's two worlds that you live in, sometimes three or four. And it's kind of crazy because I found nobody in my field here. In fact, I find a lot of people that just absolutely refuse to believe in this. And not only that, and I don't want them to believe in it. I just want them to have a little bit of sympathy or empathy, not sympathy, empathy to understand and hear me out. But it is a shutting of the door kind of thing. So the bottom line here, I don't know where I was going with that point other than to say there's a lot of times where I want to cut out of things because it's like going in that world. It's like I just want to stay in that world all the time, but you have to balance your life with your spiritual. You can't have it just one way. I mean, the monks out in the mountains, they can do that, but you know, we can't. We got a physical world here. We got to deal with people and things. There's a special kind of place there. And when I take myself out and I ground back out in the universe, there's a sensitivity that loses itself. Like the empathy kind of gets barred up a little more. I kind of get a wall up a little bit because it's like, nope, dealing with the physical world. I can't accept all of these emotions and da da da. So this is the energy they're giving me. It's like too many people are getting too gummed up and not wanting to tap into their empathetic side, their feelings, right? When I say that, oh yeah, we understand that. We don't want to tap into feelings. And this is exactly what they're telling you to dip right into. Get all soaking wet in that cup of love, because it's only until we feel that love, care, and emotion for the fellow man that we truly understand where we need to go and what we need to do. When we start to shut down those things, not only does our instinct go by the wayside, because it's all about the empathy. It's all about the empathy. The right hand receiving things empathetically, giving of things empathetically, all on the right way, where we are considerate of other people, within our dignity in respect of theirs, these kinds of things, this is what will bring you forth. There's an angel of new life that is coming forth here. It's interesting because the past card, they're showing me bring that in the more distant future. It's like that partner or that person in your future that you may want and appreciate needs to come through our own acceptance of appreciating people outward. So we start to appreciate the fellow man with love and compassion. Then we get the fellow partner with love and compassion. This is interesting. Yeah. So whatever blockages we have, we will be illuminated. So it'll be interesting, the new reading coming up here, because it is on the spiritual side. This next one's going to be on YouTube. Which is, I'm here on YouTube doing this reading, but the love readings are going into Rumble. So again, check that out. On the bottom of some of the readings, I have the links, and if not, go to my communities tab and just scroll down. When you see the music videos and stuff, that all goes down to Rumble. There's something about the way we see things, and there's something about the way we give things out and receive things with our empathy. So, you know, some of us here who may be physically of the ill, you know, ill of health on the physical side, may have a problem with one accepting love and compassion inward or seeing who is worthy of that. Or how, you know, or don't give it outward. You know, there's some kind of a blockage here I'm getting. And it has to do with giving or receiving love and compassion to others. Either we're not doing this in equal balance, or like we may want to take it on, but we're not giving of equal balance. And we may see people and resist giving. I have a problem with this because I have trust issues, right? So you have trust issues, then you look at people and you're always kind of suspicious. What's your deal? What are you after? What are you trying to take from me, right? So when you're in that mode, you cannot give properly because you're suspicious of people, right? That's on the negative side. So there's a blockage there, and that'll come up in a certain kind of way in a certain kind of person. And then if you can't give to that person openly from your heart. Yeah, I'm going through stuff like this on a level myself. And it all comes down to trust issues. I know this. Intellectually, I know this. But take me out in the physical world and put me in trust people? Nope. I will not do it. It's like every fiber of my being is going, absolutely not. Back off. You know, and that's, You gotta give to get kind of thing. And this is the problem here. Love and compassion. Okay, so I've done self-analysis. I didn't mean to put all the energy into there. But at the same time, right, they're going, you know, people can correlate your story to theirs. Da-da-da. So hopefully that makes sense to you in some kind of way. But the bottom line here is we're working hard in our immediate past here. It's bringing us to a present where we may have ill health and we're coming across a spiritual blockage. And again, if we don't believe that a spiritual blockage can come to a physical illness, that again, we will be stuck in this physical illness for a while till we figure it out. But the universe is going to align you vibrationally, like, what did I say? Like the tuning fork. They're going to set that sucker off right next to you. And it may be someone next to you going through the same thing, and then suddenly they'll tune you in. That person next to you will start vibrating or saying things, and I've had this myself, you know. I've had this myself. A telemetry example. Okay, let's go. So basically, I had a situation where I had a scenario coming at me. I didn't like it. Didn't want nothing to do with it. I stood my ground. I told the other person where it's at, what I didn't like. I put up my boundary, and I made them, what do you call that? respect it. Okay, so I not only did I put up a boundary, but I watched that boundary and make sure it wasn't crossed, which is something I never did in the past. I would set a boundary and then people would walk over it and I just wouldn't do anything. Here, I set my boundary and I set it again and I set it again. And I'm slowly getting into, but it's a laborious thing. You have to, some people, they don't, right? Now, that person that I set boundaries with, they're having the same issue. And I'm going, look at the tuna fork. It's going all over the goddamn place. It's going all over. So this is the thing. Pay attention to that. You know, sometimes it's not good to be nosy. But on the other hand, you can learn lessons from other people as well as yourself. Because sometimes it's just reverberating. Your whole circle, your social circle may be going through a whole bunch of stuff spiritually. And if you don't pay attention to what that is, you may not know you need to remove yourself from it, or you may not know that you need to put up a firmer boundary, or you may not know that somebody's crashing your boundaries and you're not paying attention, right? So this kind of thing. Yeah. And it was funny to me. I sat back later and I'm thinking about it. I'm going, wait a minute. Eeny, meeny, miny. There was so much going on here that is just a mirror. It's like one going to me, one going to the other person, one going back to them. It's like, whoa, reflections all over. And so seeing that, made me laugh. Then it made me go, yep. And guess what? Until I clear up that frequency. And this is what I'm working on as well. Clearing up things in me so that I no longer get that vibration, right? Because the vibration I was getting wasn't a pleasant vibration. It was something I did not like. And I know darn well that this is something that I can stand up for. Well, it had to do with my own time to myself kind of thing. Respect of time, yeah. That's what it was. And so, you know, these are lessons. But it can come down to little things like that. Or it can be bigger things than that. And, you know, be aware of that in your universe, in your social circles. Be aware of if you have a problem with someone or their behavior towards you and you put up a boundary, watch that they're not going through the same thing. Because this karma now is instant. It is instant. And I think, holy man, I didn't even have time to put that into my thought process before it was happening to balance things out. So I don't know if that makes sense to you, but it sure as heck made sense to me on an energetic way. And it's making more sense now, even more so because I have time to think about it. You know, when you go through your busy day, you don't think about these things as much. I think about them and then I go to bed. It's like, shut off, go to bed. So, okay, I'm rambling too much here. The angel of a new life, the partnerships, it's all about the relationships, whether it be romantic or personal or, you know, or social. It's about getting together with those of higher like mind is what they said, but of a higher frequency of your, and you want to be of your higher self. So if you are disappointed in self or not standing up for all that you believe in and letting other people tread on you, you are not of your higher self. So you got to work on that. And then once you get there, then you monitor, okay, how am I going to go through this process of, filtering now who's deserving and not deserving, and who do I spend my time with and who do I not. And yeah, for some people that's a lifelong thing that may not come through, but for others they will figure it out and they will get the answers and they will be in love and compassion and empathy, and this will get them there quicker. Okay, enough rambling. Let's get on to the dragon card. I said, you want a clarification? I was going soft and light. They're like, no, give us a dragon. Because we need, for those people that are kind of stuck, we need something drastic. So what is the dragon card that they get for the energy report for June 1st here? The black dragon. He cocoons you so that your divine potential grows. Meditate, reflect, and undergo a metamorphosis. Okay, right hand empathy, right eye wisdom. Yeah, it's kind of like taking all that empathy, wisdom, internal instinct, external instinct, all of that good stuff from the outer realms. Good stuff. I'm not talking dark stuff here. Good, grounded, love, and caring for the fellow person information. When you take that in, your potential will grow. It's like this dragon is protecting that plant, right? He's creating a psychic bubble, right? And look at those little stars coming down. That can be that instinct telling you, go over here and do over here. Or that, what did I say, that sidewinder that comes while you're standing at the gas station or whatever, at the pumps, and you overhear something. And it eerily, synchronistically applies to your life. That is no coincidence. Well, it is a coincidence, but it's meant for you to take the most out of it. And meditate, reflect. Yeah, they want you to reflect on things you don't normally have the time to do. And I'm guilty of this for the last while. I'm getting back into that field now. So I will be doing more of this. But, you know, workaholics I'm talking to here, I think, squeeze in some time, not only for self, but self and higher self. Okay? I'm trying to stay out of specific belief systems. I've been saying a lot of God lately, and I realize that there's a counter energy coming off of that. So I'm going to be as neutral as possible here. That's naturally where I come from, but I felt for the longest time to go in a certain area and say the word God more, to Christ consciousness, because I may have had some viewers in this way, and I don't disrespect that, but there is going to be an attack on this side of things, believe it or not. I mean, give me a break. Everybody's attacking everybody, and you know, even something as sacred as God power, Christ consciousness, universal energy, you're going to start attacking that, making it look bad. Yeah. So I'm trying to stay as neutral as I can here to kind of just cut right through all that. But nonetheless, the black dragon, and isn't that, is that an oxymoron or a, where it kind of cancels itself? The black dragon is protecting you. Yeah, this is interesting. Because you can have protection in any form that you imagine it. You can have it there for you. It can be a black dragon, can be a white dragon, can be a gold dragon, can be a blue dragon, can be no dragon at all. Can it be an angelic presence with wings? It can be a dinosaur. It can be any form you want. Children are great for this. They just, you know, bring in things and they morph, and they have a great time in there in the imaginary realm, because they can come in any form. And how do they go to the black for protection? Give me a minute here. Like, there's a metamorphosis that they want to happen within the self. And I think there's a metamorphosis that we want to happen within our own selves. But we kind of don't know where to go to get it. We know that something needs to change, but it's almost like we don't have the answer. We don't have the light switch to turn that one on. Okay, now everything's lit up. I know where to go. It's like there's some mysteries here, and it's because for some people, you know, they're, again, the belief system may be holding them back, maybe tunneling them out of things rather than into things. It can be blocking them. You know, when I was doing my meditation before I start these readings, I do it all off, you know, off camera, whatever. And I do my thing, and they were making me highly aware there's three veils that we have to pierce as we ground to the proper power source. So that means there's almost three levels of deception that are there that people can get tripped up by. And these are the three levels that are going to be in fight the most over this coming time here. I see within a year, like I see a year from now, they're showing me as a bulk of time, a year approximate. But again, time and space doesn't mean anything up there, but they approximate it. So it could be, you know, up to 3 years, or it could be as little as 6 months, but a longer period of time by what we measure as having this struggle where is absolutely goofy fights going on. It's like the kids, you know, they're all sitting there watching TV. Bad analogy, watching TV. But anyway, it's sit and watch TV nice. Everybody's, you know, nobody's, you know, they're all paying attention. They're all getting along. And then all of a sudden a commercial comes up and they start fighting. This is kind of the energy they're giving me. It's like people aren't seeing straight. And then they start fighting amongst each other, and they may not even know what they're fighting about, but they're hitting each other and hurting each other. This is what's going on. And that's the three veils that we have to pierce in order. And again, it's all in the evolution phase, but this could take 20 years for our souls that are here to evolve, and some of them will pass during this time. Some of them will, you know, turn right over to the other side and start fighting for the wrong fight. Some will fight for the right fight, and some just won't make it. And, yeah, this black dragon is talking about protection factors. And it's also closest to the future line, which talks about empathy and compassion for the human man. And it also talks about that clear vision. So the more that we get clear and face our issues head on, the more we'll be able to do so with the fellow man. And again, it grows, right? All that energy grows, that good energy of love and compassion grows. So that's what we're talking about here. Yeah, I think I'll leave it at that, because really what they're saying is we have to go into our communities and deal with love and compassion in this way. And when we see that you can deal with the fellow man or woman with general compassion, then you're ready and prepared to go to your soulmates and your higher field of energy. Higher field, how do you say that? Your higher frequency partner, right? It takes self-work, but this can be done in our communities. They're saying, in fact, this will probably supersede us trying to work on it within our own selves, on our own selves, like with nobody around, like excluding everybody and trying to either read books or to realize things. It's just go outward in your community with love and compassion, and you'll learn more than you can read in any book. You'll learn more than and faster than you can read in any book, because the universe is there throwing things at you left and right. All you have to do is be aware of it and look in your surroundings and search for these things. That's it. So the black dragon is there with you. He is your divine potential that wants to grow. And he's also your protection. I feel that when I see this, because it's like the universe is the dragon and you're that flower growing, and they got a bubble over you and they're sending you instinctive nudges. Go in this way, do this thing, blah, blah, blah. And it's really, again, the frequency on the earth is going to be very uncomfortable and make the wrong decisions. We can make them. And there's some people that don't feel comfortable unless they're uncomfortable doing these goofy things. They're going to have problems, no two ways. But if you are the least bit aware of uncomfort and comfort in your life, and you can fine tune those, just go in that direction alone. Yeah, this feels good. This doesn't. Okay, let's go there. But again, we have morals and boundaries here. We got to stick up for blah, blah, blah. So yeah, this is a good reading overall. I'm not too sure. This is my first kick in here. So I'm hoping I'm connecting with people. I don't know if we're in a retrograde of some sort. But I'll go over it and see if it's not too gibberish. I think we'll do okay. A lot of what's happening here is we may be feeling in our heart that we want to connect with people more. And those people that are uncomfortable with that are going to have a hard time. Those people that are willing to push through that And I feel like a lot of us are. We're willing to push through that uncomfort in order to get to a final goal of a life partner or whatnot. And they're going, the quickest way to short track that is to go outward in our community in a loving and caring way. And then boom, you'll get those loving and caring partners coming. And it could be a lot of people, you know, looking for love in all the wrong places, right? This kind of thing. And those things will just come and they'll be plunked in front of you. And it's like, yeah, that's what I was looking for all along. But again, we gotta match that frequency of love and compassion going outward, having empathy for others. That's where it starts. That's where they open the doors for you. When you have empathy and you truly caringly go outward towards another person with love and compassion, what has to happen? It has to come back to you. Boom. It has to. Yeah, it's all good. Okay. That's the energy report for June 1st. Again, first kick back in here. So it's a little light, but there's a lot of heavy stuff here. And again, hopefully I was explaining it. So for the time being, I don't know if I will attach music to this or not. They gave me a song already. Kind of makes me laugh, but I'll probably put it in there. For giggles, I guess. But yeah, a lot of metamorphosis going on. It's only up from here. We cannot go back down. In fact, if we try and go back down, it's going to feel more uncomfortable. So hang on to your love and compassion and go forward, no bounds, and you should do fine. So until the masculine feminine reports, take care, have fun, and be kind, and we will talk to you soon.